Hi friends, in this video I'm going to explain you about occurrence of metals from the lesson metals and non-metals. Before I start the concept of occurrence of metals, let us see how the metals and non-metals are occurring in the nature. Out of 92 naturally occurring elements, 70 are metals and about 22 are non-metals. Some elements show properties of both metals and non-metals. They are called metalloids. Only some metals like gold, silver, platinum, etc. are found in the free state. Most elements are found in the combined states as oxides, sulfides, carbonates, silicates, etc. Some non-metals are found in the free state like helium, neon, argon, etc. And some are found in free and combined state like sulfur, phosphorus, etc. Then how do metals occur in the nature? Metals occur in the nature in two forms, in the free state as well as in combined state. Some metals occur in free state like gold, platinum, silver, mercury, etc. And other metals occur in the form of combined state, that is sodium, calcium, potassium, aluminium, lead, copper, etc. These occur in the combined state. How do metals exist? Most metals are found in the form of minerals. The name of the minerals are usually based on the location of their discovery. Some minerals are named after their colors. Most important ores are oxides, sulfides, and carbonate minerals. Metals are usually found in ores containing minerals. They are combined with oxygen or sulfur to form oxides or sulfides. Sulfide ores are converted into oxides by heating them in air called roasting. For example, zinc sulfide to zinc oxide. Metals occur in rocks referred to as ores. The metal usually found in ores. Then what are ores? Ores are naturally occurring source of a metal. Ore is any natural occurring source of metal that we can economically extract the metal from. For example, aluminium is the most common metal in the earth's crust, occurring in all sorts of minerals. If you see the occurrence of metals in nature, we find high active metals, medium active metals, and precious metals. So, high active metals are found in the form of salts like chlorides, sulfates, carbonates, silicates, phosphates, and some medium active metals are found in the form of oxides and sulfides, and some precious and noble metals are found in the free state. When you take high active metals like they are occurred in the form of salts, I said, like potassium chloride, sodium chloride, calcium sulfate, magnesium carbonate. So the active metals are highly active metals are found in the form of salts like chloride, sulfates, carbonates, silicates, and phosphates. Whereas medium active metals are found in the form of oxides and sulfides like zinc sulfide, lead sulfide, mercuric sulfide, copper sulfide. So these medium active metals are occur in the form of oxides and sulfides, whereas these noble or precious metals are found in the free state like gold, platinum, and silver. If we see the activity series, we can know how the method of extracting metals from their ores. Like for example, if you can see potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, and aluminium, these are the topmost in the metallic series and highly reactive metals these are, and that's why these metals are extracted by the process of electrolysis. And zinc, iron, tin, lead, copper, these are less reactive metals, so these undergo heating process. These are extracted by burning with carbon. These are extracted by burning with carbon. And you have silver and gold. These are unreactive metals. They have no extraction is needed for this. Copper and mercury is extracted by burning directly in air. Copper and mercury is extracted by burning directly in air. Silver and gold doesn't need any extraction here. Directly, these can be extracted by physical methods. So this is the introduction for occurrence of metals, children. In the extraction of the metals from their ores, we call this process as metallurgy. So what is metallurgy? Metallurgy is the process of extracting or obtaining a metal from its ore, or the process of extracting pure metal from its ore is known as metallurgy. So in the next video, we shall learn about how the metals are extracted based on their reactiveness, or based on their reactiveness, how the metals are extracted in detail, we shall learn in the next video. Thank you.